discussing our fluid balance chart. So we'll start by defining what a fluid balance chart is. Okay, so a fluid balance chart is a tool that is used to monitor fluid intake and output within a specific period of time in order to allow metabolic process to function correctly. The importance of fluid balance chart are as follows. Okay, to assess the response to treatment, e.g. dehydration. To monitor patient's nutritional status, e.g. in patients who are new oral. To prevent fluid overload or less intake of fluids. Number four, to monitor kidney function. Number five, to correct electrolyte imbalance. And many more points that are there on the contents of fluid balance chart. Now, when a fluid has been prescribed, okay, it has to run at a certain flow rate. So there is a formula that is used to administer fluids. Okay, so we are saying flow rate equals doctor's order, which is the amount of fluid to be infused in, times the drop factor divided by the time in minutes. For example, 1 liter normal saline has been prescribed to be given in 24 hours. At which flow rate is it going to be running? So I say flow rate equals to 1 liter, but here we'll put it in mils. So I say 1 liter equals 1,000 mils. So say flow rate equals 1,000 times the drop factor. Remember, giving cells have got different drop factors, but I pick the one which has got the drop factor of 20. So I'll say times 20. Divide by the time in minutes. Remember, the order says 24 hours. So we'll say 24 times 60 minutes because there are 60 minutes in 1 hour. So it'll be 24 by 60. Okay, so now it will be 1,000 by 20 will give us 20,000. 24 times 60 will give us 1,440. So 20,000 divided by 1,440 will give us 13.888. And it's difficult to give fluids at a drop rate of 13.888. So we'll round it off. So now it will give us 14 drops per minute. So we're saying the flow rate will be 14 drops per minute. Okay, so here is a diagram of a fluid balance chart. Fluid balance chart, the format may be different according to different institutions. But ideally, that's how a fluid balance chart looks like. Okay, so there's a place where you need to write the amount of fluid that has been ordered, the doctor's orders, the flow rate, the doctor's signature, and the nurse's signature. Now, on the right part of the fluid balance chart, that's where we have the intake of fluids. Okay, so now there is where it's written the time, where we need to write the time that the fluid were administered. There's also a column for intravenous fluids. If a fluid has been ordered, like normal saline, you will say normal saline commenced at this time. If the patient came to tolerate orals, maybe we are giving ORIs or other fluids, you also write the oral fluids. In the column it's written oral and also indicate the time. Maybe the patient cannot tolerate orals and we are giving via NG tube, you also write the time that we've given those feeds or the fluids. Okay. Now, on the left side of the fluid balance chart, that's where we have the output. From the output, there's also time, the time. So there's also urine, the column of urine, there's also diarrhea, okay, and others, which may include maybe the patient vomited, maybe the patient came with drinks from the theater, so you can also include them. Remember, you also include the time. If we emptied the urine bag, or we'll just use the measuring jug to measure the urine, you will indicate the time. Now, when it's time now, maybe it's 24 hours, okay, you need to add up the fluids that you've given. The intravenous fluids, you add them up and write the total. The orals, you add them up and write the total. If you get by NG to feed you, add them up and write the total. Even on the output, you can also add them up. Without add them up, if it's the urine, you add them up and write the total. When you are done, you add all the fluids that were given, oral, maybe by NG tube or intravenous fluid, and write the total intake. Even on the output, you also add all of them, if it's the urine, if the patient vomited, you write the total output. Then we also include the insensible oils. The insensible oils, these are the fluids that we lose from the body and they are very difficult to measure, like sweat, tears, okay? And remember that the insensible oils may differ due to weather or age. Okay, so also include the insensible oils. So when you add them up, the total output and the insensible oils, then you need to subtract from the total intake. The answer that you found, the difference that you found is the one that you write where it's written balance. So the balance is the amount of food that is remained in the body. It's the one that will tell us now whether the patient has received more fluids than the output, or there was a larger output than the intake. It will guide us. Okay, now for example, if the fluids didn't finish, the 1000 mils of normal saline could not finish by the time you were doing the balancing, when by the time it was 24 hours, the remaining 200, you write them on the balance brought forward, because you've already balanced. Now you say balance brought forward, that's why you write the remaining 200, so that the patient can finish up the amount ordered. Okay, thank you very much. Until next time, bye bye.